instructions received by both fighters. Both fighters in the cage and ready. Cage door locked. Professor Joe Solis says that they can fight, and here we go.
Both guys orthodox. Both guys good striking, but really have a grappling specialty. Quick jab there from Arlton. One fun fact, in Arlton's corner, you see Gino Morelli. He's actually the Fury amateur welterweight champion. Teammate fighting for the 55 belt. They're looking to take over the promotion.
Ah. Ooh, Arlton gets in that heavy takedown. Good pressure against the cage. He's going to try to get his hands locked.
And I've seen him keep this type of pressure and pace up for three rounds successfully. Man, he set the cross up with a good jab, and he set that shot up with that good right hand. You know, when you throw a bomb of a punch before a shot, you make him choose. You can either defend the punch or you can defend the shot. You can't defend both.
Looks to try to rip him, Arturo, to the ground there, but Arturo's got a good over-under with his hands locked together.
Yeah, and Arlton did a good job seeing that. You know, his opponent pummeled an underhook, and instead of sticking with that losing lock, Arlton actually dug his existing underhook higher and was able to at least neutralize the hip control that Arturo was looking for. But Arturo did successfully not only defend the shot, but put his back on the cage. He reversed position.
Yeah, Arturo was looking for some good head position there, but Arlton was able to back out and use it to try to get a snap down. Didn't quite work, so back into this pressure against the cage, looking for a takedown. Arturo showing some pretty good takedown defense.
Good uppercut there from Arturo.
Arturo
using that Kimura grip to at least break the grip, but maybe even look for a reversal. He elected to punch an underhook on that Kimura side. Good knee from the clincher from Arturo as well. Both guys very diligent with their head positioning.
Ooh, goes for the outside trip, doesn't quite get it, but runs him into the cage. Oh, big suplex, but he ends
it
up
fails.
Mounted.
I mean, lat drops, fireman's carries, hip throws, you know, those takedowns, if you
that
fail
them. That was a belly
them,
to belly, man.
You get mounted. It's just such a high risk maneuver. The same reward. The reward's a takedown, but the risk is just so
big. He finds himself in an even worse position now. He was flattened out there for a second, belly down. Looks to try to front roll to get out of it, but Arturo's staying heavy with the hooks. Got a wrist control. Here we are with that common theme of the night. On the back, fishing for this rear naked choke. 10 seconds left.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, I think he was going for a lateral drop, a lat drop.
Yeah.
Those are just risky. If you hit him, great, but if you miss him, you get mounted, you get your back taken. For my money, the risk is not worth the reward.
A lot of those throws, they would consider them to be like sacrifice throws or suicide throws, in a sense where if you don't come out on top, it's going to be very detrimental to you.
Yeah, I mean, I got a list of 5 takedowns I will not go for in MMA. Okay, 1, fireman's carry. If you fail, you get your back taken, you guillotine. Okay, one of the most prolific counters for that was an early UFC fight. Gary Goodridge in the black gi, you know, counters the fireman's carry with their topside crucifix and elbows the guy, you know,
50
to
times.
Death. It was bad. Not to death, not really. He knocked him out bad, though.
But he was unconscious bad.
The lat drop, the head and arm throw, and the fireman's carry. Yeah. Those are just throws I do not like. And then the hip throw. Can it work? Yes. Can it get countered the back kick? Absolutely. And then lastly, obviously, is the Seonagi, is the over-the-shoulder throw.
It's tough.
You 3 wrestling throws and 2 judo moves that are on my no-fly list, personally.
Well, I mean, and the reasoning for it is legit. You can't put yourself in these vulnerable positions in MMA. You may be able to get away with some of those positions in judo or in jiu-jitsu or specific for wrestling, but just can't do that in the MMA cage.
Yeah, and, like, can they work? Absolutely. But if they fail, the counter is different than a failed high C or a failed sing or a failed trip.
Yeah, that's
it. It just totally exposes
risk,
your hips and your
high
back.
High risk, low reward.
Yeah.
Oh, and he's got hands together. Does Arlton. He's looking to try to get that outside trip working again.
See, great scenario. Well-timed shot there from Arlton. He went in for a double, and it was defended, so it failed. But look, he's got good topside cage control, chain wrestling off.
Had the underhook looking for the ankle pick, slides off back into the double leg. Good head position as well. Hands locked together.
One thing I got to just super compliment Arturo on is his takedown defense. Even earlier in the first, Arlton went for that double leg, ran him across the cage, tried to trip him, and Arturo stayed on his feet. That can be really discouraging for the attacker. When you hit him with good physical, technical takedowns, and they just don't work.
Takes a lot of energy out of you to try to get that repeated takedown over and over and over. If someone's real good and squirmy, got great hips, like Arturo's showing right now, it really depletes that energy source. And like you're saying, it mentally frustrates you. Do I want to keep going for these takedowns and deplete my energy?
You know, that's like cracking a guy with your best punch and then not even blinking, not even moving.
Yeah. Like, oh, this is going to be a long night.
Nice to see Arlton with that underhook. His hands were connected. There's a cool reversal there. We call it the submit mix, so I don't think that's a super accepted term. So he goes palm to palm, and he can really lift up and kind of wrench behind the neck of Arturo, but he elects to go back to a body lock, double underhooks. And he's got great control here, Arlton does, but man, Arturo is just doing such a good job of neutralizing the control. But Arlton is fighting very hard to get.
You even saw Arlton drop down to a knee there to try to get a better angle, drop his level a little better, but Arturo just hanging in there. He goes for that same type of throw, and Arturo's getting on an arm here, but I believe that Arlton's going to be able to rip his arm out of there.
Yeah, he's able to step over. And, like, that wasn't even very risky of a takedown. Oh. That this Arturo's just got unorthodox and extremely effective takedown defense.
Arlton's back in on a double leg, though. Just not wanting to stop attempting this takedown.
This is how he fought Lester Jr. He just kept shooting, kept putting his back on the cage. And he didn't fade. But, man, this for five rounds, this is
tough
to be sustainable.
We've got about 30 seconds left in this round.
Arturo's working hard, too, but I don't think he's working as hard as Arlton. And it's one thing to work hard and score takedowns and threaten submissions, but when you're working hard and not having that success, it's just tough.
About at the end of this round, 10 seconds left.
Arlton gets him down. I mean, he's got an unorthodox little neck crank.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird little schoolyard bully choke thing going on. Fighting to the absolute bell.
Neither guy looks very tired either. It's a grind of a pace.
Yeah, these guys just really pushing each other, grinding. Heavy back and forth. But as we're talking about Arlton, he's able to keep that up. He's able to keep that pace on and on and on. Arturo, I mean, he's hanging in there doing all the necessary things, preventing the takedown, staying on his feet, creating scrambles. So both of these guys going to have to make some adjustments here and try to see if one of these guys can start winning and taking the momentum of this fight over.
So, yeah, so far the story has been wrestling offense from Arlton and very effective takedown defense from Arturo. And it's actually kind of hard to call these rounds because you got to credit Arlton for the pressure, the shots, the pace, but he's just not able to score. There's a guy named Kyle Dake. He actually beat Jordan Burroughs for the Olympic spot
last year.
See, that's some damage right there.
Good
from Arlton.
Good body shot, yep.
But anyway, Dake's wrestling style was a counter-wrestling style. He was good at defending and scoring off of defense. And it challenges some of the most offensively successful guys in the world.
Yeah, you're always afraid to use your most sharp weapon because you know that they have something immediately that they're going to do to it. I watched that match between him and Burroughs, and it was a very frustrating match to watch.
Yeah, it sure was. And now you see Arturo turning him and putting Arlton's back on the wall. That's what he needs. He needs more successful control time. Joe Solis, referee, doing a good job getting out of the way.
Quick feet there by the referee, and Arlton is able to get that outside trip finally. He has a necessary body lock to get it.
Just almost in mount. He's got to clear that knee. But again, Arlton just using every inch he can create. I'm sorry, Arturo using every inch he can create, and he's back in the guard.
Arlton trying to stay heavy on top. Arturo's got that butterfly hook. See if he can use that to maybe elevate, recover a full guard, or get some sort of sweep working. But Arlton staying heavy, just grinding the shoulder, the pressure into the chin there.
Yeah, Arlton's having the most success early on in this third round. He landed a beautiful body kick right before he engaged in the shot, successfully hit that body lock trip, and now he's on top, landing some good ground and pound. It maybe just took some time for Arlton's style to finally wear beyond the initial shields of Arturo's style. because Arturo still doing a good job defending, but he's in a losing position now. Whereas before, he was never in these non-dominant positions.
Yeah, Arlton looking like he's settling in a little bit here on top, trying to get to a little bit better position, maybe looking to get to a full mount. Personally, I think staying in the half like this is good if you're on top. It locks both fighters in the same position. You have exactly what they have. There's not very many things that they can do, really, besides this really annoying lockdown to try to keep you in that position. It's one of those positions where you can kind of pass when you want to or stay and beat on them if you want to.
Yeah, the potential for control is really high from the half guard, but the potential for damage is lower. But, I mean, who cares if you're on top winning?
Exactly, right? And in the judge's eyes, if you're on top in this grappling scenario, you're winning if you're landing the punches on bottom. Obviously, no submission attempts being thrown from the bottom here, so you wouldn't look at that as any offensive attacks.
Yeah, and like say, you know, Arlton does pass the half guard into side control. I guess he can get more submissions and maybe do more damage, but the escape potential for the bottom end is also a lot higher.
Increased by so much, yes.
I tell my fighters top half guard is the goal.
Yeah, you can hang out and just pound on him all day there. I mean, we got kind of that going on here, half guard knee shield, but he is Arlton, that is able to get some good ground and pound, a few good punches landing here at the end of that round.
Yeah, that was by far the most effective round of both fighters naturally for Arlton, and I mean, he won that round undecidedly. That was an Arlton round.
I for sure would agree with you on that. Arlton did win that round, so pretty close fight up to this point. I think that if I had to say, Arlton for sure is winning up to this point after three rounds.
Yeah, I would agree. But, I mean, Arturo is very much so in this fight.
Now we have the last two rounds going into our championship rounds. We have the fourth round coming up. So this is where that extra little bit of cardio, that extra little bit of training, those few little reps, that extra round, we're going to see how much of that these fighters have done. This is where it pays off. Those last two rounds, it's hard to push through. You're like, oh, a typical fight, I'm done after three rounds. It's done, it's over with. I can go home, training's done, fight's done. No, sir, championship. You want that belt, you got two more at least.
Yeah, you can see who wants to be champ. I mean, they say if you want to be champion, it's this championship rounds. They're going to test you mentally and physically. Both guys very much so still in this fight. If anything, that was Arlton's biggest round. And he really did some output in rounds one and two, neutralized by Arturo, but he still used all the energy. One thing I've noticed with Arlton, man, he's got a tank on him. He's got a pace on him. Watch, he's going to throw something big and shoot. I mean, that's just his style.
Got him against the cage, too. Good time for it. Boom, there it is.
Accidental clash of heads on the entry, but, I mean, Arlton sticks him with some punches, closes the distance, and just gets real physical.
Yeah, he uses a big overhand there to get in on this body lock. Just kind of threw the punch through his body and got his other hand around. Good knee.
Arlton reminds me of the Juggernaut from X-Men.
Yeah.
Once you get him going forward, there's no getting him going back.
There's no stopping it.
And seriously, I've called a lot of rounds of this man fights, and once he throws some heat coming forward, he will shoot. And if he doesn't get you down, he'll at least put you back on the cage.
Got a little GSP vibe to him, huh?
Yeah.
That same kind of style. Punch, 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 shoot.
And I'll tell you, man, his best shots so far have been from that southpaw stance. I mean, he was landing some bombs right before he closed that distance.
Yeah, Arlton, I mean, he's got, you know, head position, heavy against the cage, trying to get those hands together. But, I mean, he's just smashing Arturo against the fence right now. Arturo not really able to do much, but, again, goes for that same type of drop, lat drop.
So that one was like a body lock drag,
yeah, just kind of like
down. That one, in my opinion, not as
risky.
Him down. Okay, he reverses the position.
Paid
but I mean,
off.
And then that's just what I mean about Arturo's skills and style. He has a weird way of not only turning these takedown defenses into takedowns themselves. I mean,
Arturo went to drop into a K-guard there as Arlton stood up, going for a leg lock, maybe to isolate a leg here, but very tricky position when you get smashed like that because you try to give both hands to the leg like that, you're going to eat some punches.
And you got to read the room. You got to know your customer. I mean, he knows Arlton's style. The last person you want on top of you is a guy like Arlton, so you do not drop.
Yeah,
it
you
on
don't
leg
want
locks.
To drop down on that leg like that.
Not against a guy like this.
Yeah, that juggernaut style, as you could say. Yeah. It looks like he's trying to Arlton. That is trying to get around this neck. He's got a little bit of an isolation. It seems as if.
I mean, it's under the chin, but his hands weren't connected.
Getting some attention to it now. Just a little forearm pressure.
And then I can't say enough about Arturo's defense, man. Just his takedown defense, his submission defense.
He's been hanging in there tough all night. But here in this fourth round, still not being finished yet, but we're getting a little closer as it seems.
I mean, this round, like the third, is an Arlton round. This is under the chin. He's got his hands.
Looks like he's going to go for the palm to palm here.
Arturo's right arm is in the mix. It is in the way. I don't see Arturo getting finished. Just from what we've seen so far, he's just such a...
I think he seems a little too tough for that, huh?
Yeah, and like not even a survivor. He's such a troubleshooter. I mean...
10 seconds left. He's possibly going to get out of this one.
And like he doesn't just cover. He covers and he gets up. He covers and he builds a base. There's not a quitting bone in this man's body.
That's what a referee asks for when he says to intelligently defend yourself. Yeah, you're still taking damage. Yeah, you're still in a bad spot, but you know exactly what's happening. You know exactly how to protect yourself in that position. So it's a good thing for him to know. As an amateur, you can get a finish called on you pretty quickly if you take 8 to 10 unanswered punches that you did not know how to intelligently defend.
And just keeping your hands up is not enough. And what Arturo did is he had his hands up blocking the punches, but he was building his base. He got up to his knees, then he got up to his feet. That's good defense right there.
Fifth and final round of the championship fight here. We're going to get us a winner at the end of this round, potentially sooner.
So, I mean, it's a guaranteed 2 rounds for Arlton unofficially.
Unofficially, yes.
Third and fourth. And you know what? I could see him also having won the first and second.
But
could it have gone to Arturo? Maybe so. He was on top. You know, he counted some of those lat drops.
Arguably the first. Yeah, for sure. This is, I think this is probably going to be need a finish territory for Arturo.
If you're Arturo's coaches, you say you got to finish this round. And if you're Arlton's coach, you say you got to win this round.
Yes.
A lot less stress. And man, I'd love to see Arlton strike. He throws with some conviction and some power.
Oh, and there's a little bit of it.
It's an aspect we've... heavy that body hurt
kick.
Him.
Yeah.
That hurt Arturo. But like right there, I mean, granted, I'm not going to say don't shoot and take him down and score and win, but I think just it's a little selfish of me to ask. But
you'd like to see him open up a little more, huh?
I like seeing Arlton land those shots because he throws his strikes like he shoots in with his doubles. Like the juggernaut, I mean, it's cool
to see.
We'd like
to see an Arlton TKO instead of him just taking down and ground and pound.
I'll tell you, I think we would see an Arlton KO. I mean, he doesn't throw TKO punches, he throws KO punches. Cody, you were the same way. You didn't throw the kill.
You throw to get the job done, you know. It's just easier that way. If you can throw one of them and all the lights go out, then we can just stop all this nonsense and get out of here.
I mean, let's talk to Hayden Breyers. He didn't take much time at all to put his dude to sleep.
19 seconds to throw a ninja choke on someone. I mean, just incredible, you know. But these guys, Arturo and Arlton, I mean, they're in the thick of it here, you know. We're a minute 45 left in our fifth and final round here of this 155-pound title fight. And we've got a close one. You know, we have a really close fight on our hands here, but we need some significance one way or another if we're going to go to a decision to sway these judges, I think.
And one thing that Arlton just did, he had like an impeccably well-timed and well-followed-through foot sweep, but Arturo was able to stay on his feet even though he got his foot off the ground. I mean, that's that crafty takedown defense and balance that Arturo's shown this entire fight. Whoever wins this belt, I mean, it was fought hard for. These guys spent some serious energy.
Absolutely.
They're going to go home and have a good meal and you have a good rest. I mean,
good cold beer. Well earned. Epsom salt bath. We've got a minute left in this last round.
You see, Arlton's really trying to interlock those fingers. He's got them together. And now, and again, Arturo breaks the grip, which is a good split of the hips. Chain wrestling from Arlton there. He was in on a double. He was in on a heisty. Now he's in on a body lock, almost a single.
Just sticking to him, very, very sticky, staying like Velcro, not letting Arturo have any room to do anything here.
Again, a big, almost unseen aspect of this fight is the head positioning, not only for both guys, but as Arlton has his opponent on the cage, he's always got that inside head control.
Drops back down to try to get back to a double leg and lock his hands.
See, Arturo's in on a Kimura, but...
For this Kimura, yeah.
Arlton connects his hands. Big high C lift.
DC
stop.
Slam.
Front flips him. That was awesome. And he gave the battle cry. That's what you like to see. Big shots here from Arlton. I mean,
what a way to finish this fight. Great effort there from Arlton to try to solidify in the judges' eyes. That's what you want right there. That's how you want to finish the fight.
Man, props to Arlton. I was a fan of him before. I'm a big fan of him now. That was awesome. Absolutely. To watch.
Yeah, a big battle cry let out at the end. Big slam, sacrificed his own body in the process. Said, I'm going for this, whatever.
Cody, that was no more than 2 feet from us. I mean, that was fun.
I mean, you can feel everything moving. The whole cage moved in front of us. He went heavy, heavy, heavy. Just boom.
Daniel Cormier would have been proud of
that. I loved it. Yeah.
Arturo knew he was going up and going down hard. He touched his chin.
Yeah, that was like Daniel Cormier, Dan Henderson right
Dude,
there. Yeah.
Daniel Cormier, Alex Gustafson, or
same thing. Yeah. I mean, he just
Josh Barnett.
Up.
I mean,
yep.
That was awesome.
Yeah, I'm curious to see how our judges are going to render the decision here. Very close.
I think it's safe to say Arlton won rounds four, and five, like for sure.
In my opinion, and it's just me again, unbiased and completely not a judge.
Yeah.
Not a judge whatsoever. I think that Arlton did enough to keep the title tonight.
That was a good fight.
Yeah, man, all props to Arturo Tanguma, man. That guy showed a lot of great stuff. Let's see what we have.
We go to the judges' scorecards for a decision, brought to you by the Kimura Tattoo Company in Conroe, Texas. All three judges score the fight 49-46, yep, declaring your winner by unanimous decision. And your new Fury Amateur Series lightweight champion, Ardrey!
Congratulations to Arlton, putting a stamp on that victory with that awesome high crotch front flip slam.
Yeah. And that's going to wrap up the end of our night here. 10 solid fights. We had a lot of finishes, man. We had a lot of rear naked chokes. Again, like we said, if you want to figure out at the amateur level what the most successful way to finish a fight on the ground is, it's probably that rear naked choke. And there was a lot of displays of it tonight.